In the early morning hours of December 20th of 2022, a major earthquake struck a section of northwestern California. At 2:34 a.m. local time, this earthquake occurred, waking many, which registered in as a magnitude 6.4. This quake was centered 9 miles west-southwest of the city of Ferndale. It generated substantial damage to some structures, while to a greater number of people caused items to fall off of shelves. Although some towns and communities are now without water and electricity, the damage is for the most part being quickly repaired. To explain the geologic setting of this earthquake, I will first discuss how it relates to volcanoes within the state. Although California has a wide range of volcanoes which the US Geological Survey considers to be active or potentially active, what is relevant for today's video are the three northernmost volcanoes in the state, Lassen Peak, Mount Shasta, and Medicine Lake. All three of these volcanoes are part of the Cascade Range, which is a volcanic chain that stretches from Northern California to the Silverthorne Caldera in Canada. This chain exists due to an offshore plate collision. There, in the Pacific Ocean, the Juan de Fuca plate is colliding with and subducting underneath the North American plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards and occasionally erupts onto the surface, forming a chain of volcanoes. In terms of the magnitude 6.4 earthquake which occurred, it was centered near a triple junction of the Juan de Fuca plate, Pacific plate, and North American plate. Due to the interaction of all three plates, stress easily builds up in this region, allowing for large magnitude earthquakes to occur. Per the US Geological Survey, in the last 100 years there have been 40 other earthquakes of magnitude 6 or larger within 150 miles of the magnitude 6.4 quake which just occurred. As an example, in a 125-mile-wide and 80-mile-long stretch of Earth's crust surrounding the quake, in the last 20 years, in addition to the recent 6.4, four other magnitude 6 quakes and one magnitude 7 quake have occurred. Although each of these quakes had the potential to be damaging, this quake was damaging because it was centered in close proximity to land rather than occurring far offshore. However, the earthquake which occurred was not a megathrust earthquake. Rather, it was a strike-slip earthquake where both sides of a fault line moved horizontally. This did not occur along the San Andreas Fault, but rather along one of the regional smaller strike-slip fault lines which trend to the west-northwest and northwest. As a reminder, it is not currently possible to predict when an earthquake can occur or how large it will be. However, by basing a model on the type of earthquake which occurred, its magnitude, and depth, it is possible to give a percentage chance based on statistics of various magnitude earthquakes occurring as aftershocks. As of the writing of this video, at least 14 magnitude 3 or higher aftershocks have occurred, the largest of which was a magnitude 4.9. These aftershocks could continue for months, but will decrease in relative frequency as the days after the main quake continue to increase. Most of these quakes will be quite small, although the US Geological Survey estimated a 13% chance of a magnitude 5 or larger aftershock earthquake occurring before December 27th, although this statement was made on December 20th. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Alex Free for increasing their Patreon tier on this channel's Patreon page.